Hello guys, welcome to Afronics. Today we are going to look at how to display 16x2 LCD. So with that, let us get started. Okay, I've opened my Proteus 8.12. So looking at Proteus, the component we need for this project is going to be Arduino, you know, push button 16x2 LCD, and then potentiometer. Now this is the 16x2 LCD. Why do they call it 16? Which means it has 16 columns with two rows. These are the two rows and these are the 16 columns, and each cell required to have one character or a number. So in this case we have to display either 16 characters or numbers. Okay. Now if we are going to, because this display is having a lot of pins, and how are we going to connect these pins to Arduino? So these are the connections that we have to do. Now for us to activate this 5 voltage, this is a power source. For us to activate this power of the 5 voltage, you have to come to design, then you come to this power, configure power rails, then you open it. Now we have 5 voltage here, we have to send it here to this point. So you click on this 5 voltage and then you say add, and you say okay. So this is now being configured. Now that we've done the wiring, now it is now the time for us to look at the code. So let us head on to Arduino code here. Here is the code. To begin with, this is the code. So from here, well, here is the code. And we are using here as, here we've declared the pin. That is those pin, the digital pins. We've declared the pins. That is the digital pins. Then from there we've enabled the pins, that the pin where the push button is connected to, that is pin 8. And here this is the old state that we declare this one to 0. That is to put it, as we know that push button is always at the 0 unless an input. So from here we've declared the pin mode as input, because the pin, the push button is an input device. You have to put, you know, you making it as user input. Then from there declare the push button, that is low. From there we move on to, from here we declared how to begin the LCD. We say LCD begin 16x2. That means 16 columns with two rows. So if we are going to start here, as we see now we want to declare welcoming message, which means welcome to Afronics. We started it here, that is 20. As we know this part is for columns and this part is for rows. So it means that at zero, row zero, this is zero and this is one. This is zero up to 15. Okay. Now that we are going to declare, we want to start the welcoming. The W is supposed to have a little bit space in the air. I want it to start at the second column, that is here. So it's going to start from here. So the W will be starting here and then it goes on. So that's where we are going to start at 2. At 0 means at the upper part. And the Afronics is going to start at the fourth row, that is 0, 1, 2, 3. It will be starting here. So fourth, it will be starting at that point. Now, from there, we set our cursor. From there, it's going to print this message. We know that at first, it is going to click the, it's going to display, kindly subscribe to my channel. Then whenever it, when it gives this, it's going to wait until there is an input. That's why this else is there. Okay, you give the if condition with else. So this else is waiting immediately. This one is being declared. When it runs up to here, it's going to wait, hang on until there is an input. When there is an input, this is going to be executed and stop here. So that will be the that will be the end of the code. It just give it once the input is okay, just like clicking on the on YouTube the subscribe button, and then it shows that you subscribed. Now from there, when we say immediately give the final input, is going to give you thank you for subscribing. Then it's going to stop there. This exit shows that it's going to the loop is going to end, and it's going to stick at this point. It will not go again to continue continuously. It's going to stop here until you run the code again. So that is it. This is the code. So let me show you how to copy this code. You can copy hex file. Now let me show you the easiest way to find to copy this in the Arduino board in Proteus 8.12. Now one thing you need to do, you come to files. Now from files, you have to move to references. Okay, click on reference, and when you are on reference, you have to make sure that you see the output during this. It has to compile everything. So the compilation, you have to click on upload. You click on upload so that it will show you all the hex files, all the files required. So you click on upload. So in that case, you just click, you check these two, compilation and then upload. Say okay. Now from there, you allow it to run. Now it's running. All is good. Boom, we are good to go. So in that case, let us you open this part, and then down here you look for the hex file. You see, this is the drive where it has been stored. That is from C drive up to here, where it ends with dot hex, which means hex file. Okay, now this one you cannot copy, just have to click on your computer, Control C, it will copy it. When you copy it, then you move to Arduino and the Proteus, double click it, it's going to open. And then this one, where there's a program file, you click there, and then you press Control V, and Control V is going to paste it there. He said okay, it's okay. Welcome to Afronics. Kindly subscribe to my channel. Now in this case, you just have to click on the subscription button so that it could be, it will show you another message. So if we, let me zoom it. This is it. So we just give an input here. Thank you for subscribing. Bam. That is the end. So this is what I have for you today. Thank you very much.